Well, a Brighton-based community interest company secured Arts Council England funding to create a film bringing together 42 of the UK's most experienced inclusive disability dance artists and companies. Absolutely amazing. And guess what? As I say, they're Brighton-based, which is even better. And joining me now, we have Natasha Britton and Erica Moshman, who are artistic directors of Parable Dance. Welcome to both of you. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you.
Great to see you. What a fantastic idea. How long has the company been going for?
Not very long. We formed in 2019. We've been working in inclusive dance for a number of years, but decided to set up in Brighton just in 2019. Obviously, then the pandemic hit, so it's been a challenging first couple of years.
I can imagine. So how have you actually survived the last 12 months? Because it must have been stop, go, stop, start, and doing stuff on Zoom, I assume.
We obviously haven't been able to lead in-person sessions, so lots of the practical workshops that we had planned have been cancelled. And we do a lot of mentoring for supporting other artists and observing their work, and that's obviously been cancelled because classes aren't taking place. But it kind of created a space for us to be able to develop the work that we're doing at the moment, which is this wonderful film that brings together artists from all over the country. So that's been our focus for the past
and
year.
How did you manage that?
Erica, do you want to?
Yeah, we realized when everything went into lockdown that there was no sort of way for, or that people were being able to start to connect more just over Zoom and other kind of platforms. So we thought it would be nice to try to get together a resource that people starting out in inclusive dance could come to just to kind of see what's out there. So we reached out to at first just a small handful of artists, and the response was pretty enthusiastic, so we kind of expanded from there, and then it's turned into this.
What does inclusive dance mean?
It's a very broad term, so essentially it's about including everyone in dance. It depends on the groups and the kind of the setup. It could be that it's a class that encompasses everybody and everybody's welcome within a session. It could be a session that's specifically aimed at people with learning disabilities, for example. So it's about making sure that everybody has access to dance, essentially.
Yeah. And in your film, of course, you've got people with very serious disabilities as well.
The people who feature in the film have a variety of disabilities, but they're all paid dance artists and the dance feature.
That is really unusual, isn't it? I mean, obviously, the message of dance and the language of dance is universal, and it's so important, certainly over the last 12 months, with lockdown, depression, and what have you. This must help in many ways.
I hope so. I mean, when we started out in 2019, it was one of our goals to, like, from the beginning, pay people with disabilities for their contributions, just like everybody, and we've managed to do that now for every project we have going right now is happening. So I think the main reason that we have our film is to, again, like, have a resource out there for people to utilize for if they're interested in getting into inclusive dance. But I think you'll see sort of breaks in the film. So there are people talking, and then we've got dancers as well. We have 8 dancers with varying abilities. So I hope that it is also an easing of mental health and all of that in this time as well. Yeah,
I'm sure. So why did the idea come up? You know, why the film?
I guess at the beginning of the very first lockdown, we were both very conscious of the fact that lots of our friends, you know, we have many friends in the arts who are losing work, arts organisations closing down, facing financial difficulty. And we were all kind of reaching out to each other a lot more than usual, checking in and seeing how everyone was doing. And it became quite obvious that we needed to do something collaborative to kind of keep together and support each other.
Mm-hmm.
And as well as that, you know, we wanted to create a project where we could be paying as many artists as possible so that it kind of spread the work. And,
that's good. That's nice.
Spread the income. Yeah.
Erica, what's your background?
I moved to London in 2013. I'm from New York originally, and I was working with a dance company that has disabled and non-disabled dancers. And then when I came here, I found out the vast network of inclusive dance here in the UK, which is really much bigger and more established than it is in the US. And then I kind of found my way into working with people with learning disabilities and then continued to expand from there. And I met Natasha through one of the companies that we both worked for. So I started out, I believe, 2014 here, and just have been trying to work in all areas of inclusive dance since then.
Funny enough, Natasha, that was my next question, actually, was how did you two meet? And that's just been answered. But what's your background, Natasha?
So I'm Brighton, born and bred, and I went up to Trinity Laban in London for university. And I ended up developing most of my career up in London. So taught in lots of different places, different companies for 20 years. And Parable was really a chance for us to develop the skills that, you know, the work that we wanted to create, but also for me to be able to kind of make my mark on Brighton, which is my home city. So we've established some really great partnerships in Brighton with Carousel Arts and Southeast Dance to set up weekly classes for youth and adults with learning disability.
Why for people with disabilities? Is there a reason for that?
Why not? I think, you know, our entire careers have been about opening access to everybody. For Erica and I, our main kind of area of interest is people with learning disabilities and the process that we go through in our classes to create work with those dancers. Bringing that specialism to Brighton and opening up those opportunities for people that don't currently exist in the city.
Are you actually a charity?
We're a community interest company. So with charitable aims, yeah.
So how do you survive? Is this from people who actually you teach, they pay a fee?
At the moment, I mean, the film was made possible with funding from Arts Council England. So we're really thankful for that. And before that, through personal donation or fees from workshops, fees from continuing professional development workshops and dance workshops as well.
Excellent. So what's your website? What's the address?
www.parabledance.co.uk.
And anyone can join in?
Anyone can join in. And we do have a How You Can Help Us page on there as well. So, you know, feel free to take a look at that.
Exactly. How long has it taken you to put the film together?
We heard about our funding in September, and so we had the films coming in until Christmas, and then we put the film together in the new year, and it's premiering on Wednesday.
Oh, fantastic. And when is it, when is people able to watch it? Where can they watch it?
On Parable Dance's YouTube channel, if you subscribe, there's a countdown, and the premiere is this Wednesday, the 10th at 7 p.m.
Wonderful. We shall be there. We'll make sure we cover it. But thank you so much, Steve, for talking to us today. I wish you the very best of luck. If people want to get involved with you, surely they just go to your website.
Absolutely, yes. And follow us on social media. We're on all platforms, and you'll get all the latest news coming through those channels.
Brilliant. Thank you so much, Steve. That's Natasha Britton and Erica Moshman, artistic directors of Parable Dance. And go along to their website. It'll be at the bottom of the page here. And join in, help them out any way you can. It's going to be a fantastic film to watch, that's for sure. But thank you very much, Steve, for joining us here today on Latest TV. Thank you.
Thank you.